I need this. Oh,
but I am tired.
Don't be ridiculous. It's Genyamas. Hurry.
I don't think we're going to make it, Mr. Trotter.
No, neither do I. Well, goodbye, Mrs. Trotter.
Goodbye, Mr. Trotter.
Wow, what a beginning to a story. Can you believe that? Well, I'm sorry if you start the story with such a terrible event, because his mother and father being swallowed up by an escaping rhinoceros. But I just had to tell you.
It's because of this event that this story happens. See, life is really great for our hero, James Henry Hunter, until this happens to his parents.
Now, Will, you said to make the difference to two AM. That's fine to ask by Joe. I'm sorry to point out, but I must, that they're both really poor people. They're selfish, cruel, and lazy, and right from the beginning, they started being poor James almost no reason at all.
They never called him by his real name, but all we're going to do is ask.
Here.
You take it.
It's yours.
And now all you've got to do is this.
Take a large jug of water, put all the breathing into it.
And then very slowly, one by one, add 10 hairs from your own head.
That sets them off.
And then in a few minutes, the water begins running full furiously. And as soon as that happens, drink it all down, the whole jug full, in one go.
And then, my dear, feel it churning and boiling in your stomach.
And steam will start coming out of your mouth!
And then marvelous things shall happen.
Fabulous! Unbelievable things! And you will never be miserable again in your life.
She's yours! Aren't you?
We know all about it.
Now off you go and do exactly as we said.
And don't let those little great things get away from you!
Or else they'll be working their magic. Somebody else is going to find you.
Whoever it is first, be it bug, insect, animal, or tree, that will be the one who gets the full power of their magic.
So hold it back tight.
Right, Sponge, you can practice.
more considerate of my aunt, though. Aunt Spiker says that only two things are
that's
myself.
An apple.
Maybe she's right. She's kind of spooky.
Can you imagine how they feel right now?
Have you ever been out alone on a dark, quiet night?
Here's where James knows. He can feel it in his bones.
No,
it's like he's stranger than ever is about to happen to him again. He's sure of it. He can feel it coming. Everything is so different. Suddenly the whole place seems to be alive with magic. Wow, it feels often warm. It's a little furry, like the skin of a baby mouse. Except, I don't
know it.
But there's a hole in the side. It's quite large. This sort of thing is an animal about the size of a pumpkin. This isn't just a hole, it's a tunnel. Boy, really it's damp and murky in here. These walls are wet and sticky. It tastes like pigs just dripping from the ceiling. Delicious. Now it's going up here, towards my center. This seems like a solid wall. It looks like wood, except that it's very jagged and a little deep groove. Treasury. I know what this is. I've come to the stone in the middle of the piece. And here is what appears to be a small tool cut into the face of the stone. Let's see now, there. Here, we've been waiting for you.
Oh, no! No!
I'm hungry.
I'm Spanish.
So am I.
Everyone's Spanish. We need food.
Aren't you hungry?
What's the matter with you? You look positively ill.
What's something he's going to say? 10 seconds.
Oh, my goodness, the poor thing. I do believe he thinks it's him that we are wanting to eat.
Funny little green thing, can you?
heavy tea bread turned so beautiful, so kind and well red.
And such beautiful eggs. You just wear them and then they explode and they blow off your head.
Okay.